What is the hardest math class in the world? Is it calculus? Well, in spite of what my babysitter told me when I was 7 years old, the answer is no. Is it, whoa, that is heavy. Advanced engineering mathematics? In spite of its thickness, the answer is no. How about the advanced math major subject called real analysis that will often come to you in thin books like this? Such pain and misery coming from such a thin book. Well, believe it or not, the answer is still no. For me, my hardest math class was my third quarter of my algebraic topology class when we got a new professor who decided to veer off from the main content of the book on homology, cohomology, and the fundamental group, and decided to devote the entire quarter to the study of, well, as Darth Sidious would say, spectral sequences. Both algebraic topology and certainly spectral sequences are examples of graduate level classes in math. Before we get into what happened in my class on spectral sequences, we should briefly look at what algebraic topology is. In a nutshell, algebraic topology takes abstract algebra, groups, rings, fields, certainly more advanced than what you learn in high school, and applies it to the study of topology, which in general is the study of abstract space, though you can apply it to, for example, surfaces like a sphere or a torus. Getting into a little bit more detail, homology is an example of a subject within algebraic topology where you form essentially infinite chains of groups and then take those groups and form what are called homology groups of a given space X. This homology group tells you information about the space, perhaps how many holes the space has in it of various dimensions. It turns out spectral sequences are actually ways of computing homology groups, but you can see it's much, much more complicated looking. All sorts of letters everywhere, all sorts of superscripts and subscripts and arrows. The letters often represent groups. The arrows represent homomorphisms. This filled the board of my spectral sequence class pretty much every class period, and I pretty much didn't know what was going on beyond that. But here's where the story gets kind of funny. There were only three of us in the class, and none of us knew what was going on. Every lecture, the professor again would fill up the board with these kinds of diagrams, and almost the entire lecture, he'd be speaking to the board as he wrote these diagrams. But every once in a while, maybe about 30 minutes into class or so, he'd turn around and look at us with a little grin on his face and say, "Trivial, right?" And we were all like, "Uh-huh." But we never said anything. We never asked any questions to reveal our ignorance because, well, he never assigned us any homework. So we figured maybe if we go to class every period and dutifully take notes, even though we had no idea what it was about, maybe we could pass the course, maybe even an A, even though we didn't learn anything. Well, it was going along well until the very last day of the class. In fact, the very last 10 minutes of the last day, he finished with his diagram, and he turned around and smiled and said, "Well, I guess I'm required to give you guys a final exam." Our hearts sunk. A final exam? Well, it was a take-home, so that was better than an in-class. Three questions. We had a week, we could use library resources, so we spent the week scouring the library, looking for things that might help us. I remember writing some stuff down, not really understanding what I was writing down. We all turned it in. About a month later, we get our grades. We all got B's. We passed. Amazing. I guess an A for attendance and an F on the final exam averaged out to a B. I was very thankful.